Big moment. I mean, for both of them, but particularly, I would say, for the Prime Minister, Kate.
Yeah, I mean, she must have been incredibly nervous. The understanding is that King Charles said to her that, describing his mother's death, it's the moment I've been dreading, which, again, I think is a real insight into, yes, his psyche and how he feels, but actually that he's willing to share that with the country. Those are reportable comments.
Yes.
And this is the face that he's starting to show. There's a reason for that. Of course, because he's a human being. He's just lost his mother. The fact that he has to do all of this in the first case as a, on a personal level is amazing. But I think he's trying to show that side to himself to really set a tone here. We won't know exactly what was discussed in that meeting. It will be the first of very many. There will be another one tomorrow.
And he's going to have to bite his tongue, which he's not used to doing. Charles is famous for sending his spidery letters to ministers, for opining about big issues he cares about, not least the environment and so on. He's going to have to pivot from, you know, quite gobby Prince of Wales to non-partisan, non-controversial, non-divisive monarch.
That's what's so interesting about King Charles, because we do know a lot about his views on a lot of subjects. And that absolutely wasn't the case with the Queen. And that is a big, big contrast. He, in his speech tonight, he said, I'm toning down that from now on.